Gentlemen, are you with me? Mikey V, are you with me? Giuseppe D, are you with me?
Yes, I'm here. Yes, we were discussing Joe's almonds.
Yeah, I mean, for podcast etiquette, it's not ideal. It's not ideal.
I mean, I was in a waiting room. What do you want me to do? I need a snack.
I know, and I bet you do. I'm just saying, for podcasting etiquette, you know, I'll actually say, great clip. Dave Chappelle came on the Joe Rogan show one time, and he started chewing gum, and Joe immediately asked him to not chew gum. And I just thought about, if that were me, of how hard it would be to ask Dave Chappelle not to chew gum. You know what I mean, Mikey V?
Nothing like Bob comparing himself to Joe Rogan.
That has nothing. That is
unbelievable. This
thing
guy
was more of a comparison of the circumstances.
Unbelievable. This guy, the next Rogan.
Let me tell you how that is
not far
possibly
off.
That is,
by the way, Beardown, I like the fit today.
Oh yeah,
I will.
Yeah,
tell
you look good. I like the rollback hat, the Prize Pick shirt.
Yeah, but let me tell you something. Prize Pick. This is one of the most comfortable shirts.
While we're on the topic, now is a perfect time. You got the Masters coming in, and I'll tell you this right now, Bobby Props is going to give you the chance. Not only are you going to get a free $100 when you sign up to the Prize Picks app with promo code Bobby Props, but I'm going against this guy named Book It with Trent, who's a TikTok guy, and he's affiliated with Prize Picks. I'm going head to head with him throughout the Masters tournament.
Brutal.
Every day of the week. Giuseppe, I mean, it's like you just bet. You're bashing Prize Picks. Now you're bashing an ambassador.
When did I bash Prize Picks?
You just bashed Prize Picks. You just bashed.
I did not. I said it would have been nice to get a T-shirt, or you know. And I'm not bashing Prize Picks. I'm saying I'm bashing you. You think that you could have got me a little care package, Bob? These guys hand you the world on a silver platter. You can't get me a fucking T-shirt, you know. Beardown got his payout, which was much deserved, by the way. But that being said, I was an integral part of the operation. I don't even get a hat. Nothing.
Promo code Bobby Props, and you could sign up to Prize Picks today. You get $300. And we're going to go ahead. If you tail me versus the picks with Trent and we win, they're giving out $5,000 to random winners. That is $5,000, thanks to our good friends over at Prize Picks. And now, before we start the show, I mean, before we get into really anything, there's only one way to start this show. There's just one way. And that, to me, is Fartgate number two. I think Fartgate number two is the only way to start this show. Because I'm going to tell you this right now. Joey Coldcuts went out for a round with a very pretty young lady, and it looked like you guys were having a great old time. But, and I didn't even see this. I sent it over to Mikey V immediately. We're going to get Mikey V's take on it. Coldcuts posted a video from the turn of just giving an update of what him and this lovely lady were doing out on the course, how the round was going. And I didn't notice it from a first glance, but multiple followers messaged me and said, Bob, we have Fartgate number two on our hands. And for those of you not watching on the YouTube, I recommend you do watch it on the YouTube, because you got to see Coldcuts' reaction after the alleged fart. And Jed, if you could go ahead and play the clip, you listen closely to the beginning, but now what you guys are not going to see on the audio is after he farts, he begins to giggle. Let's go ahead and rip that right now. No pun intended, but rip it, Chad.
So ridiculous. Thank God, because that was awful. I could not string together two shots.
Giuseppe. We're going to get to you, Giuseppe. But before anything, let's take it down to Mikey V. Mikey V, you saw the video. Are you calling fart or are you calling no fart here on Fartgate number two?
Joe, I love you. I'm glad you had a nice time. The lady seemed like a lovely lady. It looked like you had a really nice day, but I mean, your facial reaction to me just tells the entire story that needs to be told. I mean, there is a noise variance. As soon as you say you're saying something, you're explaining something, you say, thank God. And all of a sudden, you know, a little comes right out in your face. I mean, it just exposes you immediately. You were exposed immediately. Self-exposure, really. So yeah, 100% a fart. I think Joe did the right thing. He laughed at it, and posting it, I think, was brilliant, quite frankly, because I laughed so hard. It was great. So I think it was a known fart. I think Joe knows he farted, and I think he posted it anyway.
Well, let me tell you, Beardown. First off,
he's holding back his laughter now.
It's so beyond ridiculous.
But I will say this:
myself on this show every single week.
That's not true. Cutsy would be maybe the only guy on the planet, especially when then panning the camera to the girl ass and be there, that would fart, would let out an accidental fart and continue to post it rather than just redo the video. I wonder, is it because the girl was there that you didn't want to redo the video? I have a lot of questions, but before anything, we must give the stage here to Joey Cold Cuts. Cutsy, you got to tell me that was a fart, no?
No, it's not a fart.
Oh, I mean, bear down.
Bob, have I ever denied a fart in the past when I actually farted? Context, by the way.
Did Joe deny Fartgate 1 or no? Did he deny
Fartgate 1? No, I was going to say, he denied Fartgate 1.
No, he did. No, because I didn't, because both times. Two separate occasions, bear down, by the way. Two separate occasions. So the people who actually really follow know this is the third occasion now. The first two times were fabricated by Bob. One of the times when I was in my all pink outfit, he actually farted and blamed me, which you'll never fucking come out
because it's not true.
This is the ultimate pretzel maker. And I'm bear down, I would not make this up. Bob, I fart in public all the time. When I do, I fucking take onus. And trust me, it's a lot fucking louder than a little pipsqueak toot.
Let me stop you there, Jed. If you could just roll the from Fartgate 1. If you could go ahead and roll Fartgate 1.
Dude, did you just fart?
No. That was, you moved the fucking book. Good Lord, we already rolled this. Do we need to roll it again? Bottom line is, some fucking follower hit me up and said, did you rip ass? I said, no, absolutely not. I was with the young lady. You don't think I have the fucking, you don't think I'm gentleman enough to walk away and just rip one 5 feet away?
It's out of our control, Joe.
I do.
But I will say this, over my bodily functions.
I will say this. Joe would not strike me as a man who wouldn't admit to farting either. I got to be totally honest.
I fart just as much as the average fucking man does. And by the way, when I fart, they're fucking loud. But this time was not a fart. Joe, I was filming a video,
Joe,
Bob.
So let me, I got,
slipped out of my cheeks.
I got,
what is the, what's the explanation for the noise?
I don't know
what the noise was. This is probably some fabricated noise that Bob or somebody put in there.
You think Bob planted the noise in the video?
No, not in the video, I'm saying
it's your story, Joe. It's on your post. It's on your story. Okay.
You're innocent until proven.
Here's
guilty.
The question. Here's in the Bob's question.
Court, in Bob's court, I'm fucking guilty before I even have a word to say. I gotta go with this young lady who, by the way, shot an 86. I've never been more turned on in my entire life. She played unbelievable. And I have to go. I'm at the end of the round. I open it up, and there's stories about how I just ripped ass on the fucking court. But by the way, she follows Bob, so I had to hear the whole thing.
See, that I did not know, and that I apologize about. I didn't know she followed.
Yeah, that's great. I still put the charm on because it didn't matter. But bottom line is, it's not a good look.
But let me ask
you
this.
If I ripped ass, I would say I did.
Let me ask you this, okay? Let me ask you this. Did you have to admit, Joe, that you hear the noise that we heard, right? Can you admit that?
I may have heard something. But by the way, the first Fartgate, Beardown, and here's what I'm going to say. The first Fartgate is there's something on the fucking, on the cart, on the leather seat that moves, and it makes a noise that's very similar. Noise. Yes, yeah. It's very similar. It's the rubbing of the leather.
Leather seats are notorious for masquerading as fart sounds. That's known to a lot of people.
This is what happened the first time, not even the first time around. Bob made a fart noise with his mouth and blamed it on me.
That is the most ridiculous, preposterous.
Bob, you know what? At the end of time, when our maker fucking comes down and looks at us in our eyes, you and I are the only two people in the world who know.
I look forward.
And
to
I would
it.
Never lie about this.
I look
and
forward to it.
You,
I really do.
God
I
help
look
you,
because
this
to
is
going to
be a black stain on your heart for a long time. Than the fact that you know that's
I wouldn't
not true.
I wouldn't be the only one with the stain.
because yeah, it might be a brown stain in your pants there after your haircut.
I gotta tell you.
Now, Cut, can you explain the giggle mid-video? Why there was a giggle?
That was my next question.
The giggle was very, very.
I giggled because I said I was giggling because I said I played like shit. I was giggling because I was playing like garbage, and I was just laughing it off.
I've heard you complain about playing bad, and there has never been a giggle. No, but it's a different element.
I was with a young lady. If I was with you, I probably would have been throwing a tantrum.
But here's the best part. Here's the best part is Cutsy's driving home, Beardown, and I have no idea that the girl's in the car. So he's talking about the fart. You know, Bob, you always stage me. I didn't fart. You did this again. You did this on Fartgate 1. He goes, oh, by the way, say hello to Kathy.
Well, the fact that I would defend it in front of her just shows that I didn't do it.
She's probably thinking, what the fuck did I? And I said,
I mean, Bob, she follows all her stuff. So she knows what she's getting herself.
Yeah.
Beforehand. All right, that's fair. It's not like some girl who's coming in clean, you know, she knows the backdrop behind this.
Now, okay, so just for anything, I just want to say, you stick to the, you're saying you
fart. I am denying it 100%. I did not fart this time. By the way, there are plenty of times I will fart, and you may
you let us know. You let us know.
I'll let you know the next time I'm ready to rip wind.
Yeah.
And you can film it, and I'll smile, and I'll say that was me, because I'll take onus of the group.
All right. I would love that. I would love
that. By the way, that was a little toot. That wasn't like a manly fart whatsoever.
That's not what's up for debate. That's fine. Okay. All right. But yeah, next time when you want to fart.
It's loud and proud. It's not small.
Your
and
farts are very similar to your sneezes. And I will say, they don't come a crazy
You can hear
amount.
My fart from a mile away.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Let's move on here from the fart. Okay. Let's move on from the fart. Something else happened this week. And
oh boy.
I think this absolutely.
I thought this is what we were leading off with.
Well, when the fart.
I think it was until the fart.
When the fart happened, everything changed. But there is big time speculation in Bears camp, and if there is any type of turmoil with Chicago Bear football, you better believe Mikey V is going to be right in the middle of it, right in the heat of it, Giuseppe. And I would like to play the clip from ours truly, Jerry Don, who went to some autograph signing or whatnot and absolutely went for the neck, all of his pride, everything of QB1. The pride and joy of the Chicago Bears, Justin Fields. Jed, if we could go ahead and play that clip, please.
Jersey Jerry here. Just left the GT Sports Marketing event. You want to talk about a crumb bum scum bum punk? You're talking about the Chicago Bears quarterback. I won't even say his name because he's that irrelevant to me. That name means nothing. Disrespectful, not humble at all. Asked him for a picture. I got a roll of the eyes, and sure, I guess. Bottom of the barrel type of guy. For all you Bears fans out there, you guys should be ashamed of yourself. You really, really should to call this guy your quarterback. Just a bad, bad guy all the way around.
Now, I got to tell you, okay, from a glance, from me looking at this, first thing I thought of, oh boy, this is not good for Mikey V. Mikey V is going to have to address this. I don't think Jerry Don would lie about it. I definitely don't think Jerry Don would lie about it.
No.
And, you know, I'll also say this, that God forbid this happened to Aaron Rodgers or any part of the Packers camp. Oh. I do think Cutsy would be on. I mean,
you're not going to come for my neck.
Because I will say, as much as we love to bust Cutsy's balls, and we do, Cutsy takes big time heat when he comes back. A lot of it granted because of how much he'll run his mouth throughout the season, but he does. And I find this to be very concerning for QB1. And then, Cutsy, I'll go ahead and give it to you, and then we got to let Beardown take the stand.
Well, yeah, I was just going to say, I was going to reiterate what you said is like, I have to deal with this shit all the time. Aaron Rodgers says one thing, and I got four stories posted by Beardown. And by the way, I have transcript receipts of these stories so I could resurface them if need be. I got one with Pinocchio with the nose. I got plenty of ones.
I mean, he did. Lie.
Might be necessary.
Bottom line
might
is,
be,
I have
it
to.
Might actually be necessary.
I mean, he did.
I have to deal with this all the time, and that's over a quarterback who happens to be a two-time reigning MVP, best quarterback in the league. Justin Fields, as far as I'm concerned, whatever he did in Ohio State, that's fine. The guy's a rookie. He really hasn't done anything.
No, he hasn't.
He's done nothing. He's got nothing to show for after
You're
1 year.
Absolutely right.
Well, let's bear down.
Well, let me finish my thought, that, Bob.
That's what I'm saying. Let's let him go.
All I said was he was right.
Let him go.
He has nothing, no body of work to show. I mean, they had a losing record this year. I do, for the record, think that he's going to be a successful quarterback. So I will make the record known that. I'm not just coming for blood here, Beardown. But bottom line, this guy, you're at a signing. You're sitting in a thing where you know you're signing autographs. That's what you're there for, which, by the way, he's probably getting paid for to do. I don't care if he's – Beardown was sending pictures saying he took 3-4 pictures with families. Well, that's what he's supposed to do. You sign the pictures. You take the picture. You sign the autograph. You right. play the part. And then when you leave, you leave. It's not like Jerry Don went to a restaurant, Bob, and interrupted him while he's with his girlfriend or his family saying, can I have a picture?
I agree.
It's not a good look at all, Beardown. It's not Beardown's fault. And by the way,
not saying it's Beardown's fault.
Where I do disagree with Jerry Don is he's saying
nobody's saying it's Beardown's fault.
But I will say. But listen to me. Jerry said in the video, if you listen, the Bears fans should be ashamed of themselves. It has no recollection on Bear. It's not Beardown or any other Bears fan's fault that this is how he reacted. But you should at some point say, well, if this is how my quarterback's going to act, maybe he's a different guy than I thought.
And now I think it was very well. I think that was very well said. Now I would leave while you're ahead. I think you made a great case. And now it's only right. We let Mikey V respond. He put out a statement on Twitter today. Let's hear what Mikey V's got to say.
Well, I mean, I don't know what you guys – I know what you guys want. I mean, from the second that this happened, I was being inundated, egged on, prodded, and poked. Everyone wants to turn this into me versus Jerry, and everyone wants me to go ballistic and defend Justin Fields to the end of the earth, and I'm not going to do that. I'm going to say exactly what I said. Jerry is a dear friend of mine. I believe Jerry. I don't doubt that his interaction with Fields was bad. I spoke to him today on the phone. He called me and gave me basically all the information that some of it was exactly what people know and some stuff people don't know. And the point of sending the pictures was not to say, look at him doing good. The point was to say, I mean, he was taking pictures that day where he was in the same event smiling with other people. So what happened with Jerry that got him to the point where he didn't want to smile and didn't want to take the picture?
Did you ask that to Jerry Don?
Yeah, I did.
Okay.
And Jerry, basically, like, from my understanding is like Jerry, I don't want to go into detail because he told me something like he doesn't want repeated, which is fine. But basically he had like a VIP pass, more or less. Like, he was a paying customer. So he had a pass where he was a paying customer. There's a lot of rumors out there going around, people slandering him, saying that he was a freeloader, yada, yada, yada. That's not accurate from what I understand. That's not accurate. He wasn't general pop, though. And from what I understand, the event ended. And also I heard what Big Cat said, and I know he spoke to Jerry, and Big Cat said the event had ended. Fields went into the backstage area along with these other guys. These other guys, Jerry said, were talking to him, Jameis Winston, Freiermuth, Justin Herbert. All these guys were very cordial, talking to him, interacting with him. And basically Fields just was like walking around as if he didn't have, you know, the time of day to give Jerry.
By the
way, I'm very disappointed in hearing.
Sorry to cut you out there, Mikey V, but for the listeners, this ended up going viral on Twitter. It yes. went nuts. So it ended up being a very big deal, and it was all over.
Listen, every person I follow on Twitter and that follows me, many verified Bears beat writers and Bears reporters. And like, basically Jerry successfully in 1 hour turned an entire fan base and city against him in one foul swoop. Now, I'm going to say this also because I'm giving the whole truths, right? I'm going to give the whole truths. I spoke to somebody who's a former player.
Okay. Ryan Urlacher?
No, I'm not going to divulge, but all I could say is that there has been wind that perhaps Justin Fields carries himself with a little bit of arrogance.
Oh, I hate this so much.
Now, listen, that is, could be taken with a grain of salt. It could be taken serious, because for every person that I've heard complain about Fields, I've also seen maybe five people to that one person say the opposite about Fields and say that he was accommodating. He's a very nice guy. He's a very giving guy. There's videos of there of him with like giving like money away to kids, buying candy off, like very, very like conflicting stuff. So again, I just come back to, I don't believe Jerry's lying at all. I don't believe he's exaggerating. I think obviously Jerry knows exactly what he's doing. He's going to get a reaction out of everybody. He got a reaction out of everybody. And it blew the fuck up massively. And that's why I waited a couple days, because I wanted to have the best version, the most accurate version of the story that I could possibly have before I could speak on it. Because obviously I was inundated, because people know of our relationship with Jerry. They know about our show. They know about the meetup, all that stuff. So they wanted my take on it. And I wasn't comfortable giving it until I actually spoke to Jerry and heard other perspectives. So now, all that being said, it is what it is.
Anything Jerry Don, I immediately get looped into. So then Beardown tells me, he's like, Bob, they're using clips with your interviews with him. Yes. Jerry was always on the show. And me and Don were laughing about it, but it's funny. It's like anything Jerry, I still get looped in, because Absolutely. That's all the original clips of Jerry. Same shit with Connolly. When he was going at Connolly, I had Connolly coming to me, you fucking this, and that. It's like, Kevin, I have nothing to do with that. What Jerry wants to do is on Jerry. Jerry's my boy. He's all of our friends. But what he says, I have nothing to do with. And that's even what I would tell Connolly multiple times.
And I'll say this, for all the fun and games that it is, listen, at the end of the day, Jerry is a grown man who has an opinion on another grown man. That's it. Jerry has an opinion of another grown man. And Jerry knows, putting that out in the internet stratosphere, he's going to catch a lot of flack. And that's fine. And he knows that. He embraces it.
He does embrace
it. He told me today he's going to make it miserable for every Bears fan on the face of the planet for the entire season. And he's going to. And that's part of what it's about. That's fine. But what I will say is that for people clapping back at Jerry, he expects it. He hasn't said anything, complained about it, but I'm going to say it from my perspective, okay? Because from my perspective, how I see things, for you to go after this man's family and say things about his family or his kids, let me explain something. Nobody would ever have the balls to say those kind of things to anybody's face. They only do it over the fucking computer. It's the most ultimate coward move on the face of the earth. And that's the kind of stuff that really gets me pissed off, because yes, Jerry said some things that I don't agree with, but for people to say that kind of stuff in return, going one-on-one, man-on-man is one thing. When you bring families and kids into it, is literally like, you're the lowest form of life on the face of the earth. And you know
what's so sick is it's the internet, and it's going to happen. It's never going to go away. Man. And it's trolls so everywhere. Sick. And also too, it's even more so just in the Barstool community. That's the way their fan base is. I've talked to people that have worked at Barstool, and one in particular who said he couldn't even put his girlfriend up on Twitter or Instagram because the DMs that his girlfriend would get, that it's a malicious. Their fan base can ugly, be, bro. They're loyal, but it can get ugly over there. And I pose this question to you, Giuseppe. Okay. Yeah. Bigger diva, Aaron Rodgers or Justin Fields?
I've never heard of Aaron Rodgers turning down a photograph. I'll tell you that much.
Well, I don't know how this makes Fields a diva. It could make him an asshole. I don't think it makes him a diva.
Here's my thought process.
I think it's diva tendencies, if so.
Well, here's my thought process, okay? And this is someone, I don't necessarily agree with the lifestyle of Aaron Rodgers. I'm not here to say he's a fucking model citizen or he's, you know, he's the Good Samaritan or should be winning the Walter Payton Award. My point is, the guy is a winner. He is an MVP, and he's my quarterback. It doesn't mean I need to support him outside of the realm of the football field.
I agree with you.
And Beardown, you shouldn't take it personally just because your quarterback might be a piece of shit. He's still going to be a great quarterback. You can embrace that, and he's going to lead you to a very successful couple seasons.
I'm not taking it personally.
Beardown, relax. Relax.
No, no, I'm not saying relax. I'm just saying I think Beardown was very affected by this, Bob. I think it bothered him very much to his core.
Look, I'll tell you
who
this.
Who cares? If the guy wins, he wins.
When this first came out, that was – now, mind you, me and Cutsy were definitely stirring the pot for sure. But I Beardown
but I'm being
was
honest
a little,
right now. Like,
he had a lot on his plate.
If it really bothered – guys, you've seen me react on social media. I've gone on rants on social media. I didn't go on any rant about this. I didn't say anything about this until today formally. I didn't put out anything until today. It doesn't bother me so much, and that's exactly what I told Jerry. I said, Jerry, you know where I'm going to stand. I have to root for my guy. You know what his response was? Because he's not a dummy. His response was, of course you do.
It's a game changer, by the way, when it happens to you personally. You hear things of, oh, it happens to other people. When it happens to you personally, when Cam Newton shunned Bob forever, now will never.
I didn't know.
Oh, you didn't know about this?
No.
How did you not know about this? This is the reason Bob hates.
Bob never shared this with me.
Bob hates Cam Newton and vehemently cheers against him.
I don't.
And it's because it happened to him personally, just like what happened to Jerry.
I have a story after Bob's done. I got a story for you.
I was working at the Four Seasons Hotel.
Uh-huh.
Okay. And I clearly was in my suit, and I knew Cam Newton was coming. And a lot of the valet guys said that Cam Newton is very he's very disrespectful. He's very hard to work with. He's not a very nice guy at the hotel at all. So he was in the elevator. I walk into the elevator to go upstairs, and he's there in the elevator. So very casually, I clearly worked there. I just said, hi, Mr. Newton, how are you? Very casually. Put my head down, elevator's going up. As the elevator's going up, I could feel him looking at me. He's a big, tall guy, big presence.
6'5", yeah.
I feel him looking at me, and I look up, and he's looking right at me. And mm-hmm. he says, you don't know me. And I was very shook, and I said, no, Mr. Newton, not personally. He goes, so why would you say hello?
I mean, you're only raised to do it since you're 2 years old, and fucking jackass.
Yeah, and it shook me to my core. Now maybe he was having a bad day, but
keep dressing up like Mr. Fucking Peanut Butter or whatever.
I mean,
Nutter
you
butter.
Just I don't know. I don't know, but
that's
yeah.
My
see, point. I don't know if there was an engagement. I don't think there was any verbal thing other than he rolled his eyes, which is obviously, but for Cam Newton to say, why would you say hello to me? I mean, that is like above and beyond the most absurd thing I've ever heard.
Yeah.
So another one quickly, celebrity, not athlete. My brother's bachelor party, 2010, Harrah's Atlantic City Casino. We were at the pool all day, Harrah's indoor pool. We're leaving to go to dinner. We're getting in the limo. And who is outside unloading, getting into a limo of his own is James Gandolfini. Okay. And two of my brought, this was Sopranos was like, had just ended. It was still at like its peak of popularity. Gandolfini was like bigger than anything in the world at the time. My two of my brothers go over to him, and my brothers are a little intoxicated perhaps at this time, but very, very nicely. They go up to him, 'cause I heard the exchange, and they go, Tony, take a picture with the Uncle Fester brothers. Both my brothers are bald. So they said, take a picture with the Uncle Fester brothers. Would you take a picture? He goes, yeah, no. And just got in his limousine. And like, my brother was like, so in shock. He was like, no, he was like, we're at a hotel. Like we're both getting into limousines. Like we're getting into the limo. You could see that you're getting into a limo. We just asked for a picture. You said no. So, you know, it's now is James Gandolfini a jerk off? I've heard many things that he's horrible with the press and the paparazzi. He was awful. He would give the finger to all of them. But I've heard if you knew him on a personal level or you're friendly, he was the most friendly, like biggest teddy bear on earth. So, again, it's just one of those situations where it's just, you know, I said today, Jerry's my friend. Fields is my quarterback. I'm moving on.
We interrupt the Brilliantly Dumb Show. Why else would we be interrupting the Brilliantly Dumb Show if it wasn't for our good friends over at Manscaped? Fellas, have you started your spring cleaning yet? Because that carpet needs a cleaning. The drapes need a dusting. And of course, your lawn needs a mowing. Manscaped has the full package you need for spring cleaning this year. The Performance Package 4.0 is the only tool you need to keep your boys looking and smelling like fresh tulips, your partner, your significant other wants. Finish off your grooming routine with the Plow 2.0. Manscaped has it all. I tell you that time and time again, ladies and gentlemen, you cannot go wrong with Manscaped. The start of spring also marks the start of Testicular Cancer Awareness Month in April. Manscaped has partnered with the Testicular Cancer Society to bring the awareness to testicular cancer, men's health, and early cancer detection. Get 20% off plus free shipping with the code 20BOBBY. That's 20BOBBY. 20% off free shipping with the code 20BOBBY. It's time to throw out your old hygiene habits and upgrade your life with Manscaped today.
Bottom line with this show is that one day when we're all big stars, we got to remember the common man.
Always.
You remember the common man. You treat everybody with respect. No one's too small. No one's inferior. Everybody's, you know, equal. And you, even if you don't want to take that extra picture, you take that extra picture, Beardown.
Right. And maybe for the Bob Dust sports fans out there, this will teach Cupty to be a little bit nicer to maintenance crews.
Oh, maybe you want to talk about, I'm so nice.
That you want to talk about,
you know, I've never been disrespectful to an actual person in the maintenance just because I see it on a video. I've never gone and been out front to somebody disrespectful, Bob. And God help you if you try to make a claim that I have. Yeah, silence. Yeah. That's what I thought.
It's these guys' work, Joseph. It's
I never
these guys
have gone
work.
To an actual guy.
Well,
and
but
complained
they,
about
but
the
they
maintenance
see the video.
Him.
You see the golf course. You know what golf course we're on. What's the lead maintenance crew think about that? Giuseppe?
That's a big difference. That's a big difference.
Well, I'm just saying,
to somebody's face or turning down a photograph.
I'm just saying something
on a video.
Take something to think about. Something to think about.
I treat everybody like they're grade A stars.
Can
You're
we talk
star Joe?
Thank we, you, Beardown. I appreciate that.
Can we talk about Fat Perez for a second? Because
in what regard,
Bobby, can we play that clip that you have?
That's
him?
What I wanted to do because it's funny because like I was watching you two on live while I was on the plane, and like you guys mentioned Fat Perez and Beardown, like and Cutsy too, like you guys couldn't help but laugh just mentioning his name. Like it's like Fat Perez got mentioned.
He's hysterical.
He's an absolute riot. He was on my story this weekend of him just plastered drunk. I mean, so outrageously drunk. And we had drinks. We were there for this golf event. We go up to our room, and I called him right after because I was going to go over and hang out in his room right after. And you know Perez stays up late. Perez keeps the party going. And I called him and he didn't answer. And I'm like, fuck, that's so unlike him. So I called him a few more times and I'm like, I don't. So I had a key to his room. So I went in and I go to his room.
It's his a smart feed, move, by the way.
I was concerned.
I know that sounds insane, but that's a very smart move. Okay.
And when Perez checked into the hotel, he checked in and he gave me his key.
You know what? Good for him.
Yes. And I was like, something's not right. He should be up by now. I go over, I go into the room, and as I peek around the door, I see 2 feet hanging over the dresser. And there is Fat Perez just sprawled out, blacked out, like totally blacked out. And I tried to wake him up, you know, to straighten him out on the bed. And we will play the clip of Fat Perez now waking up. This guy is one of the funniest human beings. You can't help but just.
He's a presence.
He's a presence. Jed, if you play the clip.
He's a fucking presence.
And by the way, you can make the claim no one is quite as for the boys as Perez. Like he is down whenever you want to do, whenever you want to do it. Somehow Perez is gonna make it happen.
I invited this man to the Yankee game that we're going to in a couple weeks, all of us, and he answered within 2 seconds.
He lives in Virginia.
He lives in fucking Virginia. It's not like he lives in Connecticut and it's a couple hour drive. This man has to rearrange his entire weekend to come to this Yankee game with us. It was an instantaneous answer. He is married.
At which, by the way, he will be getting blackout drunk for sure.
But totally. Oh. Now, and
that lineup is
there was not, There was zero hesitation. And one of the highest engaging stories I've ever put up is the call after he blacked out, the call with his wife, who we do love dearly.
And Cole, God bless her,
bro. She is the same. I want to play. Jed, if you could go ahead and play this.
Fucking mess.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that would be a fair assessment.
Yeah.
Yeah, you just can't. You can't drink 30 drinks and get away with it.
How did you get so fucked up? Do you remember talking to me when you got back to your hotel room last night?
No. No, I do not.
Yeah, I was actually pretty pissed off at you.
That checks out. At least I called.
Yeah, because you didn't answer my phone when you were at the bar because you were too busy being a drunk fuck to even answer and say, hey, I can't talk right now. So you called me 2 hours later.
That's on me.
And
I gotta be better.
Call. It's one of the most incredible things I have ever heard in my life.
Oh my God.
It's absolutely unbelievable. It's absolutely,
God bless her.
God bless her. God bless Fat Perez. And it really is the year of Fat Perez. He just continues to grow and grow and grow.
Whoa. You didn't mean it like that. Come on,
Bob.
That's horrible, Joe.
That's not a way to just
following grows and grows.
You really are.
No, that is.
For you to
Bob, that is
so clear where I was going with that.
But I knew that.
Bear down. I mean, you know, come on, Bob.
You know exactly what he was.
I gotta tell you,
I'm sorry.
I gotta tell you, by the way,
I love you.
By the way, speaking of wives, I got busted this week pretty good by my wife. Yeah.
About
so the Costa Rica flight that you guys obviously I told you about for my dear friend's bachelor party in November.
She didn't know about it?
Oh no, she knows about it. Of course she knows about it. She's in the wedding, so she's going to the bachelorette party. So wherever that's going to be, and then I'm going to this one. But obviously, you guys know that I booked a
first class
ticket, and that was a little tidbit of information that I felt didn't need to be divulged quite yet. You know, but the screws were put to me, so to speak, this weekend, and I was called out. Was a ticket purchased, and I couldn't lie. I'm a horrible liar, horrible fucking liar. So I had to say, yes, the tickets were purchased. And then she started asking. She knew, right, bro, she knew. As soon as I told her, yes, the ticket was purchased, it was like I might as well have just
folded. I mean, but you
right
have an
there.
Excuse. You're in agony when you're sitting in coach.
But they agree, John. And then I tried to disguise it. I said, it's business class, not first class, which it is technically business class.
And what is that flight, like 6 hours, 7 hours?
It's the same exact thing. It's a five-hour flight, Joe.
That's a long time, though.
Is she going to be on the same flight?
No. It's different times. Different times.
I'll actually say this, if I may,
because
you guys
bear down here.
You guys were the ones who got me on to trying out first class.
How great is it, Bob?
When I left your house, Mikey V, and went back to LA, and I had the pod.
It was tremendous.
Did you do the lounge
beforehand, Bob?
I did not do the lounge.
Oh, see, that's an amateur hour. You got to do the air lounge.
But I did the pod, and the pod, it fully reclines, totally life-changing. But I will say, so I had first class going from just recently going from DC to LA, and it wasn't the pod. And I will say, and not to sound like an asshole, but going from the pod to regular first class. Yeah. Yeah. Was a big drop off.
I mean, the pod is the elite. That's the best plane to be on. Is the pod?
It was
plane.
A very big. Now, I because of that pod, I signed up to the American Airlines credit card.
Smart move.
The whole
smart move because you're flying a ton. It's smart move.
But it just doesn't. I mean, it's a.
But you
big
had the big.
Drop-off.
You had the big seat though. Obviously,
I did. Yeah,
you
I
had
did.
The big seat. You got your meal, even got though the enchilada was not up to par.
Yeah.
But, you get your free cocktails if you're interested. At that point, you might not be though.
You got to go before the flight and go in the first class or business lounge. Mm. They got drinks. They got espresso machines.
Do you know what I'm saying though?
Just a precursor.
Like, do you see how that could be like a big drop off with the?
Well, yeah, but it depends on the flight. It depends.
Yeah, it just didn't hit. But that's nearly.
I do a 12-hour flight to Europe.
That's a coast to coast flight though. That's a coast-to-coast flight, DC-LA. I would have expected that to be a
By the way,
it's that airport, you know?
No TVs either. How do you not have a TV for that flight? Yeah.
What? Did you fly on a Fred Flintstone plane?
I don't know.
Was this Spirit Airlines?
It just did not hit Southwest. The same way.
Southwest, by the way, is the biggest garbage fucking
line. I agree.
I took them to Colorado.
They line you up like your cattle cars, and they fucking make you, what a joke that is.
It was tough. It's tough. And they don't assign you a seat. You gotta
There's no assigned seats. You got to go in a little fucking lineup like you're at recess.
But my in-laws did pay for that flight. So if they are listening, I'm not complaining at all. Great flight.
Okay. Thank you. Gentlemen, I want to go into what I think is really, really a good top five. I like it a lot. It's time for us to do our food portion of the top five. And here's what I would like from you fellas today. Today we are going to be doing top five chips. Your favorite, Cutsy's got his hand up, so we're going to send it over to Cutsy.
I just had a question. Is it chip flavors or chip brands? Because what if I like two different flavors?
That was a question I had, so we could chalk that off the list. Thank you, Joe.
What?
I think it's a good question. If
it's
I
a like very Dorito, valid. Like if it's a style. Yeah, or is it Dorito General Doritos, or does it have to be Doritos Cool Ranch
Doritos, and then the specific chip?
Okay, so flavors and brands.
Correct. So it's going to be the top
that
five.
That changes everything.
Yeah, it's going to be. It's going to be
changes everything.
It's going to be the top five bags of chips. Okay. Are we all
ready to start? I cannot start.
I noticed that Cutsy does? He sets this narrative as if now he's got a scramble to give him. You know, you ever notice that?
I had a relevant question.
Whether it's a relevant question, but it could have been asked prior to the show. You knew what the top five was. It's like you give yourself a crutch before it starts off, so you can always go back on
that. Nobody who's rating on Instagram is listening to the crutch. Everybody's just based on what our answers are.
Not necessarily.
There's no precursor as to why the fucking top five was given.
Give our followers more credit, please.
I'm saying they rate the top five based on what they like or what they don't like. They're not looking at it like, oh, Cutsy scrambled by asking a question so he had more time.
Can we get into the top five, Joseph?
I would like not to start. That's all I said.
Can we get going here? Okay. Mikey V, are you ready for us?
Yeah, I'm ready. Yeah.
Do you want to start us off, Mikey V?
Do you want me to? I can start.
Sure.
All right. Okay. Number five. Fritos. Is that a problem, Fritos?
I will.
What flavor? Regular?
The regular.
Chili and cheese?
But, no, regular, Joe.
I'll give this to Cutsy. Are you okay with are we considering Fritos?
Is it a the only thing is it's a corn-based? Well, if it's corn-based, then I'll allow it.
But a lot of chips are corn-based. I don't think that's the problem. I think the problem is, are we labeling Fritos as a chip? And I would say yes. Okay. Yes. We are going to grant that. We've got Fritos at five. Take it away, Mikey V.
Fritos at five. Number four, probably the most utilized chip in my household, to be honest, the most frequently purchased chip. Got great versatility, could work with anything. And I think it's pretty damn tasty by itself. The Tostitos scoop. I'm a big Tostitos scoop guy. Love the Tostitos scoop, the salsa, the cheese, whatever. Now you guys,
adding the salsa and the stuff.
Totally no. I know that. No. I'm just talking about the chip.
Totally.
Okay.
I think it's a versatile chip.
Scoop by itself.
Yeah, I could do. I could eat.
So what are you scooping? Air?
No, I'm just
I don't like that.
Okay, let him continue, Bob. Let him continue.
I think the Tostitos scoop is an essential chip to have.
I think if you pair it with like guacamole or
something. Well, here's the thing. If you're going to have guacamole, you're going to have salsa. What chip are you buying?
Yeah, but we're just
What chip are you buying, Joe?
Yeah, Tostitos.
Tostitos scoops, right?
I actually like the hint of lime, but that's neither here nor there.
Okay, that's fine. I think the Tostitos scoop is an essential chip. That's why I don't think it could be left off. That's fine. Right. That's fine. Okay. Tostitos scoops at number four. Number three, Harvest Cheddar Sun Chip. Whoa, Sun Chips, Harvest one. Cheddar. Love Harvest Cheddar.
That's a very Sun good
Chip
one.
To me is like the most underappreciated chip, I think. Love that. I love Sun Chips, man. They're even the Garden Salsa, but my number three is the Garden Salsa is
very good.
Yeah, I like the Harvest Cheddar. Number two, I am going to do Ruffles, plain Ruffles. I like a Ruffle chip
too.
Just a plain regular Ruffle potato chip. I think the Ruffles, for whatever reason, the structure and integrity of the chip is upheld a lot better for whatever reason with the Ruffles.
It's a sturdy chip.
It is a sturdy, sturdier yeah. than a regular chip yeah, for I agree. Whatever reason.
I agree.
So yeah, the Ruffles. And then number one is my favorite flavor, and I had to attach it to a particular chip. I love a kettle cooked chip. Sour cream and onion kettle cooked chip to me is like exquisite. It's an exquisite chip. It's a top dog type of chip for me. I love sour cream and onion. I think that is like the Michael Jordan of chip flavors, the sour cream and onion. So reliable, just a all around all-star type of chip. So kettle chip, sour cream and onion would be my number one.
I think if we were doing flavors, I think sour cream and onion would be my number one. I think barbecue may be number two.
Barbecue's up there.
Barbecue's got to be up there.
Yeah.
I'm big on chips. I'm a chip guy through and through. I would like to go for number five. I would like to go Pringles, sour cream and onion. Something about getting those Pringles. I mean, it's like you don't need it with another food. Like you could just eat though. It's spectacular. Love the Pringles packaging. One of the best out there to do.
You like the tube?
Yeah, I love popping it out of the tube. Okay. I love that experience. I think it's so rare. And not nobody's really followed it. I think it's great.
It's so rare.
number four, this chip for me has grown on me and just continues to go up the ranks. I think if you caught me a year or two ago, I wouldn't say this. I think it would be honorable mention. Doritos spicy and sweet chili.
Oh, that's a really good one, Bob. That's a sleeper pick.
Oh, I love that chip. It's an exotic chip. The bag is great, that purple bag. go ahead and give me that Doritos spicy sweet chili at four. Number three, I'm going to go with a good sandwich chip, a chip that okay, literally God. Pairs nailed it better than any other chip with the sandwich, like a deli sub. Give me the Cape Cod kettle cooked chips. Give me that at three, the best sandwich chip out there. Number two is an iconic chip. One of the most famous chips out there, been doing it probably the longest, is the Doritos nacho cheese.
Yeah, that's a staple chip.
Yeah.
The red bag, classic red bag.
The old reliable, you know, the issue you do have it is it's very, you know, you get that the Dorito dust. I could do without, but I can live with it. Doritos nacho cheese at two. And then number one, I am going to go with a Ruffle. And I like what you said, Mikey V, about the sturdiness of the Ruffle. Mm. It's got like different layers, different fillers to it. But I am going with the sour cream and cheddar.
Oh, okay.
Ruffle, I think, is the number one. You could use it for a sandwich chip. You could use it straight up down the pipe. That's what I got at number one. Giuseppe D, we throw it over to you.
All right. I'm going to throw this out there. I know I don't know if it could count as honorable mention. Best snack, which it technically doesn't classify as a chip, is by far Hot Cheetos or Cheetos in general. I know I'm not going to use that. I just want to preface this by saying that is the best. I don't know what category that's in. That's by far the best. But if we're going to chips, here's my top five. Top five, I'm going to start with number five. Give me Lay's, original Lay's, really? Number five. They're just super good. They're classic. It's a classic chip. You can use it. To your credit, Beardown, you can use this with dip, like French onion and different styles.
What do you mean to my credit? Well, don't say to my credit. Well, I don't want to be tied to the Lay's classic chip. I think it's a dog shit chip. Personally.
What I'm saying is you use the Tostitos. So I'm saying similarly, you can eat this chip by itself. Now, I think you can eat this chip by itself a lot easier than a Tostitos scoop, but it's also very, very good with different dipping sauces and different types of flavored, you know, French onion dips and stuff like that. I think it's delicious with. Mm. That's for me, number five. Number four, I'm going to go with, I just changed everything.
Just real quick with the Lay's, do you consider the baked Lay's?
No, the baked are dog shit. Okay. Regular Lay's, the baked Lay's are not good. I don't like the baked ones. There's not enough flavor to them. Number four, give me Ruffles, sour cream and onion. Ruffles, sour cream and onion, I think is a very classic style chip. Very, very good. That for me is number four. Number three, I'm going to go with Doritos Cool Ranch.
Yeah, it's a great flavor.
I think the Doritos Cool Ranch is a mix up from the original nacho cheese. It's kind of like a little, it's fun. You know what I mean? It's not all the time, but it's very consistently good. Okay. Number two is Mrs. Vicky's Salt and Vinegar Classic Crunch in your mouth. Like, you just get the whole embarking crunch, the sea salt, the vinegar. I love it all. Give me every part of that chip. And number one is the king of chips. It's the Doritos Nacho Cheese. It's not close. It's absolutely it's just never going to lose. It's as the top of the top to me. Nacho cheese Doritos, I think, is number one. That's my list.
Honorable mentions, gentlemen. Beardown, we'll start with you.
I gotta be honest, I just don't really like chips. I don't. What? So
that's a terrible day.
Okay. I don't like chips.
If I may,
my list probably reflects that.
I think so.
Okay.
I do.
Oh, I mean, if I had to give an honorable mention,
I
got my balls broken for this one. You know me, boys. I do not give a fuck. You ever have Terra chips? The vegetable chips from Costco. Oh! the Terra chip. It's a classic Terra chip. Yeah.
I think I got a better shot of putting together a WWE top five than Beardown.
The Terra chip is a solid, solid chip.
This was a terrible showing from Beardown.
I'm putting it on the McGregor level. But I'll tell you this.
Is that like the carrot, the green and red?
I'm going to show you the bag. And when I show you the bag, you're going to say, oh my God, I know exactly what those are. I've seen them before. The Terra chips.
I know what you're talking about.
It's actually a very luxurious chip.
They're like straw. They're like straws.
No, they're not like straws. So you don't know what you're talking about at all, actually. So this is the bag, the Terra chip. Have you ever seen those?
Oh,
those are terrible.
Lord, those are like
fucking even worse. I was thinking of the veggie straws, Bob. Those are better than that.
That's a chip for show. That's what you put on. That is something you put on a platter to make it pop.
I think Terra chips, you know, they're healthier. They're a good option.
Oh, my. You should be disqualified for that.
I don't like fucking chips, guys.
I mean, it shows your top five.
I don't like fucking chips. I'd rather have a piece of pizza or something like a fucking Cheeto, a cookie.
Chips are a great
snack. Yeah, well, okay, fine for you. I'd rather have pretzels.
I'm going to put in my honorable mention.
I mean, your honorable mention after that is going to look sensational, Bob.
I could go with veggie straws and be just fine.
Yeah, you'd be fine. You'd be fine.
Cheese puffs, I'll allow.
I'm going to go honorable mention, actually, is the Fritos barbecue twist.
Yeah, that's a good one. Honey barbecue twist.
Yes, that's what it is.
Yeah. See, now I don't consider that a chip. It's like a spiral fusilli.
Well, I thought if we granted the
Fritos, I guess you have
Clear.
I'm actually
those are very good though. I like
them. I'm also going to do Fritos for my honorable mention, but the chili cheese Fritos, I think.
That's a good one. That's a good one. Mm. And
that's
by the way,
really good one,
gentlemen. Very good podcast. Very good podcast.
Always.
It's good to have the boys back. Love you, boys. I appreciate you, boys. To be determined on the character of Justin Fields. I mean, I think time will tell here.
You guys are something else.
Only he can reveal his true identity, Bob.
He's like Batman. He's like Batman.
And I think Giuseppe absolutely farted, and I think Beardown agrees with me on that. And that is another edition of the Brilliantly Dumb Show. We love you, folks. We appreciate you, folks. Until next time.